This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Nusantara is a contemporary Indonesian term for the Indonesian archipelago. It originated in Old Javanese and literally means archipelago. In Malay, Nusantara means the Malay world. The word Nusantara was taken from an oath by Gajah Mada in 1336, as written in the Old Javanese Para Asian and Nagarakretagama. Gajah Mada was a powerful military leader and prime minister of Majapahit who was credited with bringing the empire to its peak of glory. Gajah Mada delivered an oath called Sumpa Palapa, in which he vowed not to eat any food containing spices until he had conquered all of Nusantara under the glory of Majapahit. Today, Indonesian historians believe that the concept of Nusantara was not an idea coined by Gajah Mada for the first time in 1336. It was coined earlier in 1275 as Cakrawala Mandala Dvi Pantara by Kertanegara of Singasari. Dvi Pantara is a Sanskrit word for the islands in between. The synonym to Nusantara as both Dvipa and Nusa mean island. The term is used to describe the Southeast Asian archipelago. Kertanegara envisioned the union of Southeast Asian maritime kingdoms under Singasari as a bulwark against the rise of the expansionist Mongol Yuan dynasty in mainland China. Contents 1. Ancient concepts of Nusantara. 11. Etymology. 2. The first appearance of Nusantara concept in the 20th century. 3. Modern usage. 4. Nusantara studies. 5. See also. 6. References. 7. External links. Ancient concepts of Nusantara. Majapahit Negara Aging Grand State and Mancanegara. Provinces in eastern and central parts of Java, including islands of Madura and Bali. The extent of Majapahit. Nusantara. According to Nagarakretagama etymology, Nusantara is a Javanese word which appears in the Para Asian manuscript in Javanese. Nusantara means outer islands, from Nusa, meaning island, and Antara, within. Based on the Majapahit concept of state, the monarch had the power over three areas: Negara Aging, or the Grand State, the core kingdom, the traditional or initial area of Majapahit during its formation before entering the imperial phase. This includes the capital city and the surrounding areas where the king effectively exercises his government. The area in and around royal capital of Trowulan, port of Kangu and sections of Brantas River Valley near the capital, also mountainous areas south and southeast of capital, all the way to Penanggungan and Arjuna Welarang peaks, are the core realm of the kingdom. The Brantas River Valley Corridor, connecting Majapahit Trowulan area to Kangu and estuarine areas in Kahuripan Sidoarjo and Hujinggala Port Surabaya, are considered as parts of Negara Aging. Mancanegara, areas surrounding Negara Aging, traditionally refer to Majapahit provinces in East and Central Java. This area covered the eastern half of Java, with all its provinces ruled by the Bhre's dukes, the king's close relatives. These areas are directly influenced by Javanese Majapahit court culture, and obliged to pay annual tributes. These areas usually possess their own rulers that might be directly related, foster an alliance, or intermarried with the Majapahit royal family. Majapahit stationed their officials and officers in these places and regulate their foreign trade activities and collect taxes, yet they enjoyed substantial internal autonomy. This includes the rest of Java Island, Madura and Bali. However, in later period, overseas provinces which has developed culture reflected or comparable to those of Java, or possess significant trading importance, are also considered as Mancanegara. Either the province has their own native rulers subject vassal to the king, or a regent appointed and sent by the king to rule the region. This realm includes Dharmasraya, Pagaruying, Lampung and Palembang in Sumatra. Nusantara, areas which do not reflect Javanese culture, but are included as colonies and they had to pay annual tribute. They enjoyed substantial autonomy and internal freedom, and Majapahit did not necessarily station their officials or military officers here. However, any challenges on Majapahit oversight might draw severe response. These areas, such as the vassal kingdoms and colonies in Malay Peninsula, Borneo, Lesser Sunda Islands, Sulawesi and Maluku. The first appearance of Nusantara concept in the 20th century. Modern Wawasan Nusantara. The Indonesian archipelago. Each baselines pursuant to Article 47, Paragraph 9, of the UNCLOS in 1920, Ernest François Eugène Deuze Dekker 1879-1950, who was also known as Seti Abudi, introduced a new name for this proposed independent country successor state of colonial Dutch East Indies, which, unlike its currently used name of Indonesia, did not contain any words etymologically inherited from the name of India or the Indies. The new proposed name name was the locally developed name Nusantara. This is the first instance of the term Nusantara appearing after it had been written into Para-Ashan manuscript. The definition of Nusantara introduced by Seti Abudi is different to the 14th century definition of the term during the Majapahit era. Nusantara described vassal areas to be conquered. Seti Abudi didn't want this aggressive connotation, so he defined Nusantara as all the Indonesian regions from Sabang as far as Merauke. Modern usage today in Indonesian, Nusantara is synonymous with Indonesian archipelago or the national territory of Indonesia. In this sense, the term Nusantara excludes Malaysia, Singapore, Brunei, and the Philippines, while in Malaysian this term is synonymous and often interchangeable with Malay archipelago or Malay realm. Malay, Alam Melayu, which includes those countries. Nusantara studies. The Nusantara Society in Moscow conducts studies on the Nusantara region's history, culture, languages and politics. See also Indonesia. Portal names of Indonesia. Nusantara Society. History of Indonesia. Nusantau Maritime Trading and Communication Network. Nanyang Region. References. Carrot Eccles, John M., Shadeli, Hassan 1989, Kamus Indonesia. Ingris N. Indonesian English Dictionary. First ed., Jakarta, Gramedia, ISBN. Indonesia. Environmental Issues. Geology. Islands. Lakes. Mountains. National Parks. Natural History. Fauna. Flora. Rivers. Volcanoes. Politics. Administrative Divisions. Provinces. Cabinet. Constitution. Elections. Foreign Relations. Human Rights. Law Enforcement. Military. Pancasila. People's Consultative Assembly. Police. Political Parties. President. Economy. Agriculture. Aviation. Banks. Energy. Palm Oil Production. Science and Technology. Stock Exchange. Telecommunications. Tourism. Transport. Water supply and sanitation. Culture. Architecture. Art. Boutique. Cinema. Cuisine. Dance. ICAT. Heroes. Legends. Literature. Martial arts. Media. Music. Properties. Public holidays. Sport. Demographics. Education. Ethnic groups. Health. Languages. Nusantara. Religion. Women. Symbols. Anthem. Costume. Emblem. Faunal emblems. Asian. Arowana. Javan. Hawk. Eagle. Komodo. Dragon. Flag. Floral emblems. Common. Jasmine. Moon. Orchid. Giant. Padma. Garuda. Motto. Personification. Songs. Tree. Outline. Index. Book. Category. Portal. Gallery. Atlas.